Hello, and welcome to Lean Excel Solutions. Today we will learn to create this sales dashboard in Power BI. In the earlier video, we have created the same dashboard in Microsoft Excel. Now, using the same database, we will design it in the Power BI. Some of the features are explained there in detail. Like, an overview of dashboard visuals, formulae, linkage, background design, etc. So, if you wish to watch it for better learning, the link is provided in the description, also at the end of this video, or you can click here. Alright, we are going to design this dashboard with the following steps. First, import the data to Power BI. Second, edit it in Power Query Editor to prepare the primary database. Third, create columns and measures for data analysis. Fourth, create visuals. Fifth, format the dashboard background. And the last, format visuals. You can directly go to any steps by clicking on the timeline provided in the description. So let's start with the first steps. These are the sheets, which we are going to use for creating the dashboard. Let's open on blank Power BI report and import the files to it. Here we can see the imported data. Click on Edit Query, it will open new window for Power Query Editor. Let's add some basic columns like day, year and month, with respect to date columns. Extract only first three character of the month. Now, using merge queries, let's add the columns from master data. We already have product ID column in this table, so extract remaining columns. And now, let's close and apply the changes. Now, let's add new columns for total buying values and total selling value. Create new measures for profit and profit percentage. Alright, the data preparation is completed now. Let's go back to report and add visuals. First, slices, 4-year, month, sales type and mode of payment. Use list slicer for year and month. and drop down for sales type and payment mode. Add total selling value and use card visual for it. Copy it and paste 6 times so that we can use same format for other visuals like profit, profit percentage, top product and category. Change the data linkage according visuals. Now, to extract data for top product and top category, we will use the filters here. Let's add stacked column chart for monthly visual. Sorted by month instead of selling value. Here we can see month are sorted as per alphabetic order and not as per month order. To sort it as per month order, let's go to data, select month name column and sort it as per month column, which has month number. Now, we can see, visuals are corrected accordingly. On hover over the column, it shows month and value. Let's add profit percentage too. To do so, just drag and drop profit percentage to tooltips. We can see, it is added here. Let's add the remaining visuals. Let's do some formatting, like remove category, title and background color from visuals. Now, all visuals including slices are linked with each other. But, we don't want to link this month's slicer with monthly visual. And also sales type and payment mode. So, let's go to Format tab, and click on the Edit Interactions. And you can see, these filters and none symbol will start appearing on all visual, except the one we selected. So, let's click on none symbol to delink monthly visual from month slicer. Let's do the same for sales type and payment mode. Here we can see, the monthly visual is not changing now on selection in month slicer. Now for background design, let's go to PowerPoint. These are the backgrounds we have designed in earlier tutorial for Excel dashboard. We will use this one for Power BI. It is copied from above slide and changes some color combinations and added title and icons to it. To add it as a background in Excel, we just selected all, copied and pasted in Excel. But for Power BI, we have to save it as an image first. To do that, just select all, right-click and select Save as Picture option. But if you are using older version of Excel, this option will not be there. So after copying, you can open Paint, paste it and save as an image. Or you can use snipping tools to capture image and save it. You can find many more options online to do that. These are the color palettes we are going to use for this dashboard, which we will see later. Alright, let's go back to Power BI. Under Page Background, click on Add Image and select the one which we have saved. Change Transparency to 0 and select Fit here. Here is the background updated for our dashboard. Let's remove the slicer background. Now, instead of changing the colors one by one for visuals, let's do the changes in theme colors directly. Go to Customized Current Theme. Since our dashboard background theme is dark, change text colors first to white. Let's align the visuals first. Now, as we have seen earlier, these are the colors we will use here. Let's change it quickly. Let's complete the remaining formatting now. So, our dashboard is ready now. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up, and subscribe to the channel if you have not yet subscribed. Thanks for watching.